So in the enzyme chapter, we are going to discuss the last part. So in previous classes, we are discussing so many basic things about the enzymes and all. So many basic things we have discussed in last class. So today in that class, we are going to discuss about the isoenzymes and the overall therapeutic applications of enzymes. So isoenzymes are, it's nothing but it's a multiple forms of the same enzyme. So the same enzyme, it's available in the different conformations or different forms. So it is called as a multiple forms. So if any enzymes is present in multiple forms and it catalyzes the same reaction, that is important. So the same person, it's having in different character, it's carry out the same action, means it is called as isoenzymes. So the isoenzymes means these are the enzymes is available in multiple forms, but it's going to catalyze the same reaction. So it is called as isoenzyme, otherwise isozymes. So it's differ in their physical and chemical properties. That is another one thing is. It's different in their physical and chemical properties, including structure, electrophilic and immunological properties, and the Km values, Vmax values, pH, all those things may differ. So these are the difference may be there based upon their forms. It may differ the Km value, Vmax, pH, optimal activity, then electrophilic nature, physicochemical properties, it must be different. So based upon the forms, these are the parameters also is going to differ. Yeah. So many of the isoenzymes are tissue specific. That means it's going to mostly effective, otherwise is going to active on tissues. So all those isoenzymes is catalyze the same reactions. It may same or different Km value and Vmax value. So in previous point, we have discussed the isoforms is may produce the differing pH values and Km value, Vmax value. But at the same time, in some of the isoenzymes, it may produce the, it catalyze the same reaction. But same otherwise is may differ for the particularly the Km and Vmax value. That means the Km and Vmax value, it may be same. Otherwise, it's also may be differ. It's also possible. The important isoenzymes, two of the enzymes I have included here. The one is lactate dehydrogenase. The second one is creatinine phosphokinase. So how we can explain means the isoenzymes may synthesized from different genes. That is first one point. We know that the chromosomes is having a multiple number of genes. So the different genes, it's may responsible for a different form of the same enzyme. That means lactate dehydrogenase. Named wise, it's lactate dehydrogenase. But different genes is produced different kind of isoforms. So the isoforms is may differ. The enzyme is same, but the isoforms are different. So it's called as isoenzyme. So we can see the first example, malate dehydrogenase, the cytosol and mitochondria, both things is going to, both the places may present, but the forms is differ. So the next one is tetrameric or oligomeric enzymes is consist more than one type of subunits. So normally we know that the enzymes are protein substance. It's made up of polypeptides. So in our biological system, it's may available in the multiple form. So monomer, dimer, tetramer, hexamer. So it's available in the different form. So here you can see the picture. Actually, this is one unit. This is one subunit. This is second subunit. This is third subunit. Here four subunit is there. So the same enzyme, single enzyme, it's made up of four different subunits. So that means four subunits is going to join together. It's a oligomeric or tetrameric form. So the example, best example is lactate dehydrogenase. It comes under the tetrameric forms. So the enzyme may be active as monomer also. That means each and every enzyme is having different format. the enzymes is may have been one subunit, or is two subunit, or three subunit, or four subunit. But whatever it is, even it is active in monomer also. Monomer means only one subunit is there. Even it's having one subunit also, it's may active. It's not mandatory. It must be there three subunit or four subunit. It is not like that. Even it's having a single subunit, it's a monomer. That's also it may be active. So based upon the enzyme, it may differ. So you can see there in glycoprotein enzymes, it's difference in the carbohydrate content. So if the enzyme is comes under the glycoprotein character means, so based upon the carbohydrate content, the isoforms may differ. The example, alkaline phosphatase enzyme. So in detail, we are detail the particularly this type of enzyme, alkaline phosphatase enzyme, detail we have studied in next slides. So the first one, I said different isoenzymes there. Here I have explained some of the four important isoenzymes. The first one is lactate dehydrogenase enzymes. So it's simply denoted as a LDH. So the isoforms. So why I have mentioned the LDH, the first means this is a well known or well studied enzyme, particularly the isoforms. So because the normally the LDH, its name is L-lactate NAD oxidoreductase enzyme category. So what is the exact role of this enzyme means? It is useful for the interconversion of lactate into pyruvate. You can see there the lactic acid is converted into the pyruvic acid, lactate to pyruvate with the help of LDH, with the help of LDH, lactate dehydrogenase enzyme. This reaction is interconversible. That means lactate is converted into pyruvate. At the same time, the pyruvate also is converted, the lactate is converted into pyruvate. At the same time, that pyruvate also is come back to the lactate form. So it's an interconversible reaction. The reaction has been catalyzed by LDH, lactate dehydrogenase enzyme. That's a single enzyme. Lactate dehydrogenase is a single enzyme, but it's available in five different isoforms. The named as here 1 to 5, LDH 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5. So the each and every enzyme having some unique role. The enzyme is same, but it's each and everything is may differ based upon their physicochemical properties. Same thing. How we can differentiate means once we have take this different isoforms, we can run in the gel electrophoresis. Either it is a starch or agarose. Gel electrophoresis means, so based upon the electrophilic nature, its traveling is going to differ, because it's more, you can see there LDH is more positively charged, so fastest electrophilic mobility. So it's a positive charge. Once we have go for the gel electrophoresis means it's very fastly is going to move. That means it's going to distance move far, is having distance traveled from the starting point. If compared to LDH5, it's the slowest traveling time, because it's the electrophoresis mobility is very less. So on next picture, you can easily understand. So before that, we must know the slide structure of the LDH. So I already say that LDH, the enzyme may be in different format or as different subunit is there. So LDH is a tetrameric enzyme. So you can see here. So four subunit is there. 1, 2, 3, 4 subunit is there. So the four subunit is, they are named based upon some basic rules. So here, so majorly they are termed as a two subunits, M and H. Here the four tetrameric nature is there, but the subunit they are termed as majorly two, M and H. So M means muscle, H means heart. So M, H. So four, based upon this M and H, we are, next slide, you can see that M subunit is very basic in nature. H subunit is very acidic in nature. So four tetramer is there. So majorly they are divided into two, M and H form. So the M is majorly present in muscle. Two H means is denoted as a heart. So the isoenzymes is contain either one or both subunits. So it's going to suffer like a Latin square. M and H both is having arranged. So based upon the presence of M and H, it's the isomers form is differ. Okay. So in this picture, you can easily know that. So you can see that this is a four tetrameric form, 1, 2, 4. So the same four tetrameric form, it's made up of H. So we have previously, we know that the two subunits, M and H. This four mers is made up of H means, that means H subunit means it is LDH. You can able to follow. So these are the four tetramer. This four tetramer is fully made up of H subunit means it is LDH. So it's mostly present on the heart and RBC. It's mostly available in the heart and RBC. The electrophilic mobility is very fast. So, and even though they are mentioned how much percentage is present available in the normal serum. So the LDH2 means, here you can see there, out of four, three H subunit is there, only one M subunit. So one M subunit, three H subunit is there, means it is LDH2 form. So the based upon shuffling of the both H and M subunit, the isoforms are differ. You can see there LDH3 is 2-2. 2 H subunit, 2 M subunit. LD4, 1 H unit and 3 M unit. H5, it's totally is made up of 4 M unit. So the based upon arrangements of 2 subunits, so the isoforms are differ. Once these isoforms are differ means the electrophilic mobility and their physicochemical properties may differ. So out of this five isoforms, the LDHT is more. So in serum, the 35% LDH is there. So this is the major characteristic feature of LDH. So then how it's going to significance? What is the significance? So what is the use of this LDH isoform central means? You can correlate our physiological action. You can see there the first LDH1. So we know that the LDH1 is totally made up of four tetramer. So it's a four protein polypeptide junction is there. So it is a tetramer, but it's made up of full and full H subunits. So the LDH1, it's made up of four H subunits. So it's predominantly found in heart muscles. So mostly it's present on the heart muscles. So what's the thing is, hence the pyruvate is not converted into the lactate because the LDH1 isoform has been inhibited by pyruvate itself. That means it's going to catalyze the lactate to pyruvate. That's a common reaction. But that pyruvate itself, it's going to inhibit the enzyme. So what's happened? The interconversion step. We know that the first initial reactions, the interconversion step, lactate to pyruvate, then pyruvate to lactate. This is interconversion step. So the once the pyruvate is formed, it's going to inhibit the LDH1. So what's happened? The reversible reaction has been inhibited. So the pyruvate not converted into lactate in cardiac muscles, but it's converted into acetyl-CoA, then it enter into the citric cycle. That's the reason whenever the continuously heart is going to beat work, the lactate is not going to accumulate because it's converted into pyruvate. The pyruvate is never come back to lactate. It's the pyruvate is converted into acetyl-CoA. It's converted into citric acid. Sorry, it's entered into the citric acid cycle for energy requirement. But the scenarios may differ in skeletal muscles. The first one is heart muscle. In skeletal muscles, the LDH5, because it's made up of four M subunits, so it's mostly present on the skeletal muscles. Here, what the thing is, the inhibition of this enzyme's pyruvate is minimal. Here also, the pyruvate is going to form the first initial reaction, but the pyruvate, the inhibition process, the pyruvate going to inhibit the lactate dehydrogenation. That reaction is very, very minimal. That means the pyruvate is convert into lactate. That means it's what's indicate the formed product, the pyruvate is very minimal amount is going to inhibit the pyruvate to lactate transformation. That means more amount of lactate is going to form. Okay. Because the LDH5, this enzyme, LDH5, it's having low KM value. That means it's having higher affinity. That's the reason it's having low KM value. But LDH1, it's having high KM value because it's a low affinity with pyruvate. Simply, you know, the you can understand the LDH5 is low affinity with pyruvate. Here, LD5 is high affinity with pyruvate. That's a scenario. So from this point, how can we can say that? You simply can understand. Whenever you have doing some physical exercise continuously, means it's your skeletal muscle is going to work out that time. Because of this phenomena, what's happened? The lactate is formation is more amount of lactate is lead to the lactic acid formation or lactic as a acidosis. That's the reason you can feel more strain on these particular muscles. If you have worked out the temples, you have worked out for your biceps continuously, you have taken 100 temples, means what's happened? The continuous exercise, it's more amount of energy is required, so it's continuously is going to work out. Glucose is going to convert the formation. That time, more amount of lactate is going to form. It's converted into the lactic acid. Because of that last phenomena, we know that pyruvate is going to minimal affinity with that. That's phenomena. It's more amount of the lactate is going to form. It's lactic acids. That's the reason you can feel the very pain sensation, or it may lead to the inflammation also. That's a reason, but it's never happen in heart, because heart also is continuously work out. Heart also continuously is going to working. It's going to utilize the glucose, is converted into the pyruvate, lactate into pyruvate, but the pyruvate, it's never come back to lactate. That's a reason your heart is not at all is going to feel the pain and physiological conditions. So this is one of the major parameter. From this parameter, we can evaluate the abnormal conditions. Those things we have seen in the coming slides. So the diagnostic applications here, you can see that based upon this phenomena, you can see that this is a gel electrophoresis. This is a four isoforms. Is there na? This is a four isoforms of LDH. So normally this is a gel electrophoresis. That means your isoforms is put into the gel electrophoresis. We have based upon the intensity of the peak, they are draw the graph. So normally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is there. So normally the two peak is more. The one is LDH, one is very less. Okay. But in patient with myocardial infraction, those who are having myocardial infraction, heart problem is there, that time, what's happened? This LDH1 level is very more. So normally is very less, but in myocardial patients, infraction patients, the LDH level is more. But at the same time, so this is one of the main tool to determine whether the patient's having myocardial infraction or not. So you can see that the LDH level is much greater than the normally the LDH2 is higher than the LDH1 in serum. But in during the myocardial infraction condition, the LDH1 is the greater than the LDH2 within 12 hours. Once it's happened, within 12 hours, the LDH level is very greater than the 2. Based upon the same parameter, LDH5 is there. So during the liver disease condition, normally the level is very less. During liver disease condition, like a Jaundice or any other inflammation condition or disease conditions, chronic inflammation or chronic cirrhosis condition, that time the LDH5 is more. So based upon this enzymatical parameter, we can identify whether the patient's having ill, otherwise what's the reason. Those things we can determine. So the other one important point is there. So normally the LDH activities in RBC is 80 to 100 times is more than the serum. That means it's RBC is more specific with the LDH activity. So what's happened? Once you are going to determine the LDH level, means it's never going for the hemolysis. The hemolysis means destruction of blood cells. Once the blood cells is going to destruct, means it's released more amount of LDH. So it may produce the false positive results because it's more amount is going to involve in RBC. So during blood, during the evaluation of this LDH test, hemolysis happen means RBC is going to destruct, it release more amount of LDH. So it may produce false positive results. So that's a important things. So the second isoenzyme is creatinine phosphokinin CPK. here also things, what's the role of CPK means? It is responsible for conversion of phosphocreatinine into creatinine. This reaction also interconvertible reaction. So the phosphocreatinine, it's converted into creatinine. Okay, so this reaction has been catalyzed by CPK. Here also thing is, based upon how we can differentiate now 2H and M. The same manner here also, this isoenzymes is composed of two subunits, M and B. M is going to denote the muscle, B is going to denote the brain, or both. So here the isoforms are, three different isoforms has been identified, CPK1, 2 and 3. The CPK1 is made up of two subunits. The two subunits is having B. That means two subunits is made up of B, brain subunits. So it's predominantly it's present on brain. The second subunit is made up of equal M and B. One subunit is muscle, one subunit is brain. So it's made up of M and B. It's present on heart. So CPK3, it's both is present on the muscle. So it's available in the skeletal muscles. So here you can see there, if it is a normal healthy individuals, the CPK2, it is made up of one subunit of muscle, one subunit of brain. It's mostly predominant on present on the heart. So the CPK2 in normal individual, it is very, very, very trace amount is there. Resemble to undetectable amount is there. So out of total 100%, only 2% is present in the serum. But during myocardial infarction, otherwise after myocardial infractions, within 6 to 18 hours, the CPK2 level is increased in serum more than the 20%. From 2% to 20% is going to high during myocardial infarction, otherwise after the myocardial infarction. So it is also one of the nice tool to determine the whether the patient is the myocardial, whether there really is myocardial infarction or not. Otherwise, due to the myocardial infarction, we can easily identify with the CPK2 enzyme level. But the CPK2 isoenzymes is not elevate in skeletal muscle because the CPK2 is mostly present on heart. So only CPK3 are present on muscles. Okay. So the estimation of CPK is a earliest reliable indication for myocardial infarctions. That means those who are having risk, previously, they have identified this enzyme means is one of the reliable tool to identify the whether they are going to myocardial infarction or not. So it, we can easily identify. So the next one is ALP, alkaline phosphatase enzyme. So here they are divided into the six isoforms. This is a monomer. So previously we have studied is a first one is LDH. It's a tetramer. So we have seen here this enzyme alkaline phosphatase is the best example. It's a monomer. That means it's having only one polypeptide. Out of four chains, it's having only one chain is there. The isoenzymes, they are divided into six categories. So they are termed as alpha and beta. Here alpha itself, they are divided into whether it's going for heat label or heat stable enzyme. So based upon the things, they are divided. So what is the role of this enzyme means? It is, so you can see there. So increase the alpha 2 heat label alkaline phosphatase means it indicates the hepatitis. So it's one of the nice tool. Here you can see there the pre-beta alkaline phosphatase indicate the bone disease. So that one is isoenzymes for alcohol dehydrogenase. So what's the role of this enzyme? Here it's a heterodimer. So here also it's available in the two different isoforms. One is alpha beta one isoforms, and the second one is alpha beta two form. So alcohol dehydrogenase is available in two forms, alpha beta one and alpha beta two. So what the thing is, when compared to Europeans and Asian peoples, the American and the Asians, it's mostly the alpha beta one isoenzymes are predominant. That means those people having alpha beta 1 isoenzymes. But Asians, the particularly the Japanese and Chinese peoples, they are predominant with alpha B2 enzymes. So alcohol dehydrogenase enzymes, the specifically alpha beta 2 isoenzymes predominantly present on in Japanese and Chinese people. Beta 1 is present on mostly Europeans, American and European peoples. So this scenario is always going to implicate the things means. What is the role of this enzyme? First, we must understand that this alcohol dehydrogenase enzyme, it's responsible for conversion of alcohol into acetaldehyde. So that is a first conversion for metabolic of alcohol product. So alcohol is converted into acetaldehyde. That's a first conversion. That's a responsible for alcohol dehydrogenase enzyme. That enzyme is responsible for the conversion of that reactions. After that, this acetaldehyde, it's immediately converted into the acetyl-CoA with the help of aldehyde dehydrogenase enzyme. That is second step. So this first step conversion is catalyzed by this enzyme, alcohol dehydrogenase enzyme. So once this accumulation of acetaldehyde is happened, means once this alcohol is converted into acetaldehyde, means immediately it's converted into acetyl-CoA. Otherwise, it's going to accumulate, means it's having some side effects. It's produced tachycardia. That means increase the heart rate and facial flushings. Otherwise, it may lead to vomiting. Nausea, vomiting is there. And it may have so many discomfort we may produce. Here, what's the problem? That Japanese and Chinese people is more sensitive with this problem issue because they are having more sensitivity with alcohol because due to the presence of alpha beta 2 iso enzymes. Because those people having alpha beta 2 enzymes, those people are high sensitive with alcohol. So when compared to European people, these people have taken even minimal amount of alcohol also, immediately they can feel the this kind of side effects.